It's about 2:30 p.m. now. My first conference call was at 6 a.m. this morning. I finished working at about 1 a.m. last night, and my last call with the Australians is at 11 p.m. tonight. And I'm not the only one that lives like this. Americans are seriously addicted to working hard. It's one of the reasons I came to live in New York. And it doesn't take a scientist to know that you're probably not very efficient when you're sleep deprived. Obviously, we're all about the caffeine, but when I found out that there was something even more effective than my 3 p.m. Diet Coke hit, I was intrigued. New Yorkers and most shift workers are monophasic sleepers, meaning we have two distinctive parts of our days, one being awake and one being asleep. But we are in the minority. 85% of mammalian species are polyphasic sleepers, meaning that they sleep in intervals. Are humans really supposed to be monophasic sleepers? I mean, we need to nap as children, and we need to nap when we get older, and many Mediterranean cultures love a nap. So why are most adults so against the afternoon nap? Napping seems to have bad press. It's seen as lazy or weak or for people who have low standards. But what if I told you a good old-fashioned daytime snooze could actually improve your standards? Interested? A study at NASA on their military pilots found that a 40-minute nap improved performance by 34%. And alertness by 100%. Multiple studies from the University of Michigan show that there's benefits of napping on your ability to learn, your reaction time, your logical reasoning, your symbol recognition, and that naps are good for your mood, making you less impulsive and arming you with a greater tolerance for frustration. But we're all busy, so exactly how long should you nap for? Well, apparently it's quite an art form. If you're a newcomer to napping, or if you're sleep deprived, you're at risk of falling into a deep sleep quite quickly, which can be hard to wake up from. This feeling is known as sleep inertia, and it can leave you feeling groggy, the opposite of what you're aiming for. So newbie snoozers are advised to take shorter naps, only 10 to 20 minutes long. But 10 to 20 minutes is ideal for a boost in energy and alertness. It seems that more experienced nappers are practiced at avoiding deep sleep and can enjoy longer periods of nap rest without that sleepy hangover. A 60-minute nap delivers improvement in remembering facts, faces, and names. So build a nap into your pre-party preparation to win over the crowd. If you've got the luxury of a full 90 minutes, then you can fit in an entire sleep cycle, complete with REM sleep, and avoid the sleep inertia afterwards. You'll also get maximum nap benefits, including improved emotional and procedural memory, and a boost in creativity. One study showed that people who were sitting a test attained the same learning benefits after a 90-minute nap than after an 8-hour sleep period. So if you're studying or sitting an exam, nap for a full sleep cycle of 90 minutes just after you study and before your exam, if you can. Research shows that your ability to retrieve facts from your memory can improve fivefold, five times better memory recollection, and all you have to do is take a nap. With all the research to prove that naps are great for productivity, creativity, and morale, it's no wonder that leading brands like Nike and Google are setting up designated nap pods for their workers. In fact, napping at work is becoming way more accepted around the globe. In Greece, where short siestas are encouraged, studies show that in those who nap twice a week, the rate of coronary heart disease falls by 12%. Nap three times a week, and it falls by a huge 37%. In America, where heart disease is the leading cause of death, we just might be able to snooze our way back to better health. But what do you guys think of naps? Has this video inspired you to take them more often? I know it has for me. So let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching ScIQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.